Why do telomeres shorten to begin with? And so to answer this, what I want to do is I want to use your imagination a little bit here and pretend that a chromosome is actually like the top layer of bricks on a brick wall. So let's get rid of the bricks, just leave the brick wall, and this is a chromosome. It's a long string of beads. Think of the bricks as the beads. And when a cell divides, the chromosome needs to be duplicated or replicated. And so inside the cell, and this is more accurate than you would believe what I'm about to show you, but inside the cell there's going to be a brick layer that goes along laying a new row of bricks, okay, to make the new chromosome that's going to be identical to the old chromosome, so it's essentially replicated. Now this is a long, arduous process. Remember, chromosomes are like 100 million bases in length. And so this has to be accurate because any mistakes will lead to mutations. Now where we're really interested though today is what's happening at the very end, so the telomere. Okay, so when the brick layer gets there, there's going to be a problem. You're going to see that the brick layer, unfortunately, is standing on top of the wall, so the brick layer can't replicate the very tip of the chromosome. Telomeres do not shorten by something chewing them away. It's not an active process. Well, they do a little bit, but the main cause of telomere shortening isn't something chewing them away. It's the lack of a process. It's the cells lose, don't have the ability to replicate the very tip because that brick layer falls off. The brick layer inside of a cell is called DNA polymerase 1. It gets there, it cannot replicate the very tip, so the new chromosome is shorter. So now, this cell divides, it gets ready to divide again, the brick layer comes along, laying more bricks, and again the brick layer is going to fall off. And as a result, the telomeres are shorter. And every time it gets shorter and shorter. Again, no matter what you do, no matter how well you eat, no matter how much you exercise, no matter how much you do, everything your doctor tells you to do, you can't stop this. The big dilemma that faced a lot of scientists a long time ago is that if telomeres shorten every time a cell divides, why is it our children are born young? Why aren't they born old? Because reproduction requires cell division. And so wouldn't you think that their telomeres would be shorter than yours if you had to go through a lot of cell division to make a child? So this was a dilemma people were wondering. There had to be something in our reproductive cells that prevented telomere shortening. And this is where I actually entered the picture. I led the research that discovered this enzyme called telomerase. This is a cartoon. The green is the DNA molecule, the very tip of the telomere. This factory-looking thing is this enzyme called telomerase. And what it's showing here doing is it's adding nucleotides or bases. Remember, some units of bases. These bases are being added onto the tip to lengthen the telomeres. This is what's happening in our reproductive cells. So let's go back to this bricklaying model. In our reproductive cells, the brick layer is still going to fall off the end of this wall when it gets there. But like an angel, telomerase comes in and replaces that missing brick. And so this is what happens in our reproductive cells, and this is why our telomeres don't shorten. Now, the next question is, what happens if we get telomerase in all of our cells? And this is research that I did shortly thereafter after discovering telomerase. We put the gene for telomerase into normal human skin cells, first grown in a petri dish, and then further experiments. And we showed that when we, this is like, I want to say almost 20 years ago now, when we put telomerase into these cells and the telomere shortening stopped, these cells stopped showing any signs of aging. They essentially became immortal growing in the petri dish.